إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ثم أما بعد، حياكم الله أيها الإخوة والأخوات، حياكم الله وآواكم وبياكم وطبتم وطب ممشاكم وتبوأتم من الجنة منزلا. وأسأل الله تعالى الذي جمعنا في هذا المكان المبارك على طاعته أن يجمعنا تحت ظل عرشه يوم لا ظل إلا ظله. رسالة أقدمها لكل من يعاني من أي من الأزمات، رسالة من الله سبحانه وتعالى إلى هؤلاء الذين أصيبوا بأي من المصائب. ولكن قبل ذلك سوف أشارككم رحلة إلى مستشفى من المستشفيات هنا في هذه المنطقة، أحدثكم بما صار معي هناك، ثم تأتي أو يأتي من بعد ذلك الرسالة من الله عز وجل. It's a message I'd like to deliver today, but the message today is coming straight from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To all those who may be going through some sort of difficulties, and probably we all are that person. كلنا ذاك الرجل. Everybody here may be going through some sort of difficulty, be it sickness, loss of wealth, health, families, whatever the difficulty that you be or may be suffering from is, a message comes straight from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to all of you here. First, I'd like to share with you an incident that happened when a bunch of these imams who went to this hospital to visit the sick. And I always encourage people to go and visit the sick. So here we are in this hospital and then visiting a person. And then we hear, by the way, when the imam stands for the khutbah, and I don't know why I have to keep saying this every time I come, subhanAllah. When the imam stands for the khutbah, put down your phone. When the imam starts and stands for the khutbah, you should not be talking. You should not be talking, you should not be praying, you should not be doing nothing other than listening to the imam. Why? Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, حتى مس الحصى ومن مس الحصى فقد لغى ومن لغى فلا جمعة له. Playing with the carpet or playing at the time, they did not have these carpets that we have today. They have like hasa, like pebbles. The Prophet says, even if you were to play with the pebble, like you know, you're listening, but your hands are with the pebbles, it will be considered as lagu. And whoever does lagu, his jum'ah will be nullified. As if you're just wasting your time. Here, we can relate that to playing with the phone. What are you doing with your phone? Ya akhi, can't you give up 20 minutes a week to Allah Azza wa Jal for a message? And I kept saying this message is from Allah. Can't you leave that text into later? يعني بعدين, text all you want. This incident that happened. And then we hear the person screaming next door. I ask the nurse, what is going on? Why that person is screaming? We're feeding him.
طيب try to feed him through because he's suffering and screaming maybe through these tubes to the veins IV whatever she says we're only giving him water through the tubes and that is causing him so much pain subhanallah yeah. We said alhamdulillah on the hallway we see a person walking tubes coming out of him an oxygen tank he's holding into ya imams please make dua for me and then we said what is wrong you have any wishes you know when I was to make a dua for you what's your wish he said Sheikh my wish is to be able to go to the washroom peacefully that's all he comes to the hospital every day for 8 hours a day to go to this dialysis process to cleanse the blood because of his kidney right he cannot go to the washroom just like you and I to just with all due respect just to urinate akramakum Allah may Allah honor you he cannot urinate so he goes to the hospital 8 hours cooped up in front of these feces to get that cleansing happens they said alhamdulillah and then we spot a man sitting on a chair but sitting in such a very awkward way and they wonder akhi can't you just sit properly why are you sitting in a way that makes you feel like you're tawadha lillah ma tawadha lillah rafa'a we've been already judgmental And then the guy says, Imams, make dua for me. What's wrong with you, akhi? He says, I'm not able to sit properly. That's all. And this is why I'm sitting like this, because I can't sit properly like everybody else. And this is, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. You're able to sit. You're able to walk. You're able to eat. You're able to use the washroom. Say alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah.
Hence comes my message. Or better yet, the message comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As I said, to all those who may be going through some sort of suffering. To all those who may be going through some sort of hardship. What is the message? The message is, إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الصَّابِرِينَ والله يحب الصابرين إن الله مع الصابرين The message is Allah is with الصابرين Those who show patience Allah loves them and Allah is with them The key is الصبر Whatever suffering that you are going through looking to get married looking for a job debt that you may be having a sickness, a dad, a mom, a child, a son, a daughter, a boss, whatever your difficulty that you're going through for maybe months or years, وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الصَّابِرِينَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ Allah is with الصابرين. And the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم says, إِذَا أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ قَوْمًا إِبْتَلَاهُمْ إِذَا أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ قَوْمًا إِبْتَلَاهُمْ When Allah loves a person, He shall put them under test. Alhamdulillah. Allahumma lak alhamd. When Allah loves a person, He shall trial him or her. He shall test him or her. وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ شَيْءٍ نَكِرَ فِي سِيَاقِ الْإِثْبَاتِ تُفِيدُ الْعُمُوءِ شَيْءٍ أي شيء وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ أُولَئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ And we shall trial you, as Allah says, we shall certainly test you. Allah did not say with fear. Allah said, with a touch of fear. ما قال ولنبلونكم من الخوف. لا قال ولنبلونكم من الخوف إذا كانت هذه الأمة أمة الخائفين والخائفات. ولكن قال بشيء. You know, شيء, brothers and sisters in Arabic, just a thing. He did not say, we shall try you with fear. He says, we shall try you with just a touch. A touch of fear. You want to talk about the real fear? Ask the people in Palestine. Ask the people in Sham. Ask the people in Lebanon. If you want to talk about the real fear. Allah here says, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ And we shall certainly test you with a touch of fear, hunger, famine, وَنَقْسٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ And a loss of wealth, life, businesses, whatever. وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ And give glad tidings to the sabirin, to those who are patient, as they are enduring the hardships. Give them glad tidings of what? Give them glad tidings to those who say, Inna lillah. This is very important, brothers and sisters. Those who face calamity, what do they say? They say, Inna lillah. We belong to Allah. To Allah we belong and to Him we shall return. Listen to this, brothers and sisters. Allah هو المعطي. Allah يعطي ويأخذ. Allah gives and He takes. Today you're healthy, tomorrow you may not be. Today you're sitting right here, mashallah, la quwwata illa, as those who are sitting on a chair, or maybe on a wheelchair. They were just like you and I some time back. They were able to sit just like this, but today they cannot. Today you're able to walk, maybe tomorrow you may not be able to. Today you're poor, inshallah, tomorrow you'll be wealthy, or maybe today you're wealthy, Allahu A'lam what's going to happen tomorrow. Allah gives and Allah takes. Remember this. He gives. This is why His name is Al-Warith. What is Al-Warith? Al-Warith is the supreme inheritor. The one who inherits everything goes back to Him. Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Nuh, you suffered for a week or two, or a month or two, or a year or two, or 5 years or 10 years. Nuh, 950 years. 950 years, what was he doing? Rabbi inni da'awtu qawmi laylan wa nahara. 24/7, day and night, laylan, nahara, day, night and day, giving da'wah to his people. What's the outcome? فَلَمْ يَزِدْهُمْ دُعَاءِ إِلَّا فِرَارًا. They only fled away from me. Night, day, I did my job all the time, overtime, full time, day and night. Wait, I did not spare, no time, Ya Rabbi going around. But at the end, they did not listen. Ibrahim, imagine all the fathers were here. May Allah forbid, imagine. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he sees a vision. Get up, Ibrahim. Go get your son and go sacrifice him. What kind of test is this? What kind of ibtila is this? Take your son who you've been waiting and longing for years. 90 years. Now that Allah has blessed you with a son, go and sacrifice him. Yalla. Go. Ibrahim. And Yaqub miskin. Jacob miskin, a son after a son, and he cries, and it's okay to cry. He cries and cries and cries. فَارْتَدَّ بَصِيرًا until he lost his sight. He was not able to cry no more. Tears turned into blood. What kind of ibtila is this? And Rasulullah, the master of all, one ibtila after another. He buried all his children except one, Fatima. Imagine a person loses a child, a loved one. Prophet Muhammad, he buried his own children one after another. Zainab wa Umm Kulthum, Before that, their mother Khadija. And then his children, Abdullah and Ibrahim, one after another, he goes and he buries them. What kind of ibtila is this?
والله يحب الصابرين إن الله مع الصابرين.
Your key brothers and sisters is this. Your cure is this. Here's your cure. واستعينوا بالصبر والصلاة. Your cure, your prescription is this. Seek help with what? Sabr, patience and salah. Your cure is this. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. You go to any difficulty. Here's the key. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. Your cure is this. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين.
This is your prescription. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. The dua of Yunus عليه السلام. الصبر، الصلاة. And then at the end what you get? You get the fruit. You get the gift. And what is this gift? This is the best of the best. This is the best. This is the gift that you will get off of this. What is it? I shall mention it after صلاة جلسة الاستراحة. قل قولي هذا واستغفروا بل لا تستغفروا إن هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. يقول عليه الصلاة والسلام في الحديث الذي أخرجه الترمذي وحسنه الألباني: إن الله لا يكتب للعبد المنزلة في الجنة لا يبلغها بعمله فلا يزال يبتليه ويرزقه الصبر حتى يبلغه إياها. سمعت الحديث لما سمعت؟ The Prophet Muhammad says, say Alhamdulillah, read. The Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala has deemed or decreed a rank for his slave in Jannah. For the particular person in Jannah. Which he cannot attain to his ibadah. His salah will not make him get to that place. His siyam will not get him attain that place. His sadaqah will not make him attend that place. So what happens? Allah has already decreed this particular person, he has this particular rank in Jannah. He will not get to his ibadah. What does he do? Allah Azza wa Jal, he keeps on testing him and trying him and trying him and blessing him with patience to go through this calamity or whatever the hardship is going through. Because this is what we call as-sabr billah. As-sabr billah. What is as-sabr billah? Sabr by, because you cannot be patient unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps you to be patient. So Allah keeps on trying you and blessing you with patience to go through this hardship until you achieve or you attain the place in Jannah or the rank in Jannah that Allah has ordained for you. So Alhamdulillah. Whatever you're suffering from, Alhamdulillah. Complain about a son or the father or the mother or the daughter or the boss or the health or the neighbor or this or that or the boss or the manager or the person running the mission or the complaining about whatever that you're complaining about for years and years you're complaining. A health, be it a health, hijab, whatever the complaint is that you are enduring. Ya Rabbi, I'm suffering for this. It's really, I'm through a lot of hard time with this. For 20 years I've been suffering from this. Ayyub, 18 years of suffering. And at the end he couldn't make a proper dua. His dua was, Rabbi masani yadduru wa anta arhamur rahimin. 18 years of suffering. Ayyub alayhi salam. And at the end he says, Rabbi masani yadduru. I've been afflicted with the dur, with the harm. And you are arhamur rahimin. Do as you wish. You are the most merciful, Ya Rabbi. Do as you wish. Say Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah.
And la taqnat. Please remember. La taqnat. In kunta maridan, sayashfik Allah. In kunta fariqiran, sawfa yughnik Allah.
إن كنت مديونا يرفع الله عنك دينك بإذن الله. لا تقنط. لا تقنط. Don't despair from the mercy of Allah. If you're sick, inshallah, Allah will give you the cure. Don't despair. If you are poor, inshallah, Allah will make you free of want. If you are childless, inshallah, Allah will bless you with righteous kids. Just don't miss despair. لا تقنط. If you're seeking a spouse, inshallah, Allah will bless you with a spouse. Righteous, inshallah. Just don't despair. لا تقنط. And rest assured of this. If you're going through any difficulty or hardship or hard time, rest assured that there's someone much worse than you who's going to something much, much worse than you. For sure. If you're suffering from something you think this is too much, think of your brothers and sisters in Palestine. And you shall say Alhamdulillah. They are saying Alhamdulillah. And they don't even claim that they're complaining. They don't complain at all, those people. They don't complain. They're happy. Because they know it's from Allah and they say, Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Ya hayya Allah bil ibtila. If it's coming from Allah, this ibtila is coming from Allah, certainly. Alhamdulillah. Welcome. Welcome, ya ibtila. Welcome, welcome. We've been awaiting right here. Alhamdulillah, it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahu yuhibbu as-sabirin. Wallahu inna Allah ma'a as-sabirin. Allah loves them and Allah is with those who are patient. And I will end with this. And I want you to memorize this dua. This lady by the name of Ummu Salama, she was married to her husband Abu Salama, who he died in this battlefield. So she was really sad. She went through a lot of pain, remorse, grief, as she's, you know, she lost her husband. But then she came to know the dua from Rasulullah. And the dua goes like this. The dua goes, Allahumma jini fi musibati wa khluf li khairan minha. This is the dua that I'd like everyone to memorize. Allahumma ajirni or Allahumma ajirni fi musibati wa khluf li khairan minha. One more time. Allahumma ajirni fi musibati wa khluf li khairan minha. O Allah, reward me for my calamity and compensate me with something better. Compensate me with something better. She's saying, my husband, huh, sisters? My husband, the love of my eyes, the love of my heart, my soul has passed away. And the dua says, compensate me with something better. Who's better than my husband, Abu Salama? Who's better than my husband, Abu Salama? But she said the dua from her heart. Allahumma ajirni fi musibati wa khlufli khayran minha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewarded her for her patience. And he blessed her with another husband by the name of Muhammad Rasulullah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Is Muhammad better than Abu Salama?
Yes.
No brainer. Allahumma ajli fi musibati wa khluf li khayran minha. Brothers and sisters, if Allah, إذا ابتلاك الله, ما ابتلاك إلا ليطهرك. ما ابتلاك إلا ليقربك منه. If Allah is causing you some ابتلاء, this ابتلاء, this trial is only to purify you. It's only to cleanse you. It's only to get you close to Him. Say Alhamdulillah. Whatever it is, Alhamdulillah. There's nothing we could do. To Allah we belong and to Him we shall return. But rest assured, there's always khair for you in it. وَعَسَى تَكْرَهُ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَعَسَى تُحِبُّ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ شَرٌّ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. This is it. This is it. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to alleviate anybody who's going through any pain. Ya Rabbi, reward them for their patience and grant them something better. Ya Rabbi, Amen. Bless them. Ya Rabbi, reward them. Amen. Anybody who lost a son or a child, Ya Rabbi, reward them with their patience and grant them something better. Ya Rabbi, somebody who's lost a job, Ya Rabbi, reward them for something that is better. Amen. Ya Rabbi, somebody who lost a business, Ya Rabbi, reward them and compensate them for something that is better. Amen. Ya Rabbi, someone who's sick, Ya Arhamar Rahimin, Ya Arhamar Rahimin, grant them Ash-Shifa because there is no Shafi except you. You are Ash-Shafi Rabbil Alameen. Grant them and reward them for their patience. Ya Rabbi Alameen, a person who lost a father or a mother or a loved one, Ya Rabbi, reward them for their patience and grant their parents the highest level in Jannah. Allahumma ahdina fi man hadayt, wa afina fi man afayt, wa tawallana fi man tawallayt. Allahumma ahdina wa hdina wa ij'alna sababan liman ihtada. Allahumma arina al-haqq haqqan warzuqna ittiba'ah, wa arina al-batila batilan warzuqna ijtinabah. Allahumma ya muqallib al-qulub thabbit qulubana ala deenik. Allahumma ya musarrif al-qulub sarrif qulubana ala ta'atik. La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inna kunna min adh-dhalimin. La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inna kunna min adh-dhalimin. Allahumma sall ikhwana al-mustad'afina fi kulli makan. اللهم انصر اخواننا المستضعفين في الشام اللهم انصرهم يا رب العالمين في فلسطين اللهم انصرهم يا رب العالمين في لبنان اللهم انصرهم في السودان اللهم انصرهم في اليمن اللهم يا رب انصرهم في كشمير اللهم انصرهم في روهينيا اللهم انصرهم يا رب العالمين في كل مكان يا ارحم الراحمين انصر اخواننا المستضعفين في غزة اللهم انصرهم في الضفة اللهم انصرهم في رفح يا رب انصرهم اينما كانوا يا رب العالمين اللهم ثبت اقدامهم اللهم امن خوفهم اللهم امن خائفهم اللهم يا رب اجبر كسرهم اللهم اجبر كسرهم اللهم اقهر عدوهم اللهم اقهر عدوهم اللهم يا رب العالمين زلزل الارض من تحت ارجلهم يا رب العالمين يا ارحم الراحمين لا ترفع لهم رايه اللهم لا تحقق لهم غايه اللهم ان فيهم ايه اللهم يا ارحم الراحمين برحمتك نستغيث واغيثنا اللهم اجرنا في مصائبنا واخلفنا خيرا منها اللهم اجرنا في مصائبنا واخلف لنا خيرا منها اللهم اجرنا في مصائبنا واخلف لنا خيرا منها برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين عباد الله ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى ونهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون واقيموا الصلاه